It's very important to the process of understanding Google Cloud and passing the certification exam that you go through the question and attempt answering it yourself first. So pause the video, work through the question. We'll catch up in just a little while and I'll show you how I do it. In this scenario, several teams in your company want to use Cloud Build to deploy to their own Google Kubernetes Engine clusters. The clusters are in projects that are dedicated to each team. The teams only have access to their own projects. One team should not have access to the cluster of another team. You are in charge of designing the Cloud Build setup and want to follow Google recommended practices. What should you do? So in this scenario, there are several teams. They all have a GKE cluster to deploy to. They're using Cloud Build to do the deployment to GKE. Each team has its own project. It has its own cluster. And we want to retain that isolation and segregation. We are in charge of designing the setup. What is the right way that we do this following Google recommended practices? Now, one thing to know before we carry on is that Cloud Build uses a special service account to execute builds. For your project, when you enable Cloud Build API, it automatically creates a service account and it grants a Cloud Build role for your project. This role has the permissions to do several things, like reading from the source repository, container registry, from cloud storage, and logging. But then, if you wanted to do additional things, like deploying to Kubernetes, those permissions must be granted separately. These service accounts also follow a particular pattern in the email that you have for the account, or the email ID that you have for the account. That is project number at cloudbuild.gserviceaccount.com. So you can easily identify which is the service account associated with Cloud Build. And to see these service accounts, you can go via the IAM menu in the Google Cloud Console. With that understanding now, let's try and solution this requirement. Option A suggests that we limit each team member's access so that they only have access to their team's clusters. Ask each team member to install the gcloud CLI and authenticate themselves by running gcloud in it. Ask each team member to execute Cloud Build builds by using the gcloud builds submit. Now, the first part of this, of limiting access for each team member, follows the principle of least privilege. And that is something we want. We want each team to only have access to their cluster, their project. Therefore, this is a good thing. The second part about each person authenticating himself or herself and using that to do the Cloud Build, let's look at that. Managing the permissions for each user in this setup is going to increase the overhead for the administrative team, for the IT team. So that would not be preferable. Moreover, since Cloud Build already has a service account created, we ideally do not want each individual account running the builds from that account itself. We should ideally be using the service account. So based on these two latter points, I can confidently eliminate option A. Option B suggests that we create a single project for Cloud Build and all the teams will use that. We list the service accounts in this project, identify the one used by Cloud Build, and grant the permissions required to deploy into Kubernetes Engine. Let's break that down. Now, a single project for build, that's definitely not what we want, because the requirement is that we isolate each of these teams. We don't want them seeing what is happening on the other team's project or build. If you did a common project for the cloud build and you give everybody access, then it just becomes open for everybody, and that fails us based on this requirement. The second part of the question, to list the service accounts in the project and to identify the one used by cloud build, that is useful. Instead of each person using their own account like the previous option, here we are using a consistent service account associated with cloud build. And then we will give it permissions to do the deployment. So even though that part is good, it's a bit too late because we cannot live with the option of having a single project for all the builds. That is not acceptable. So based on that, we are going to eliminate option B. Option D suggests, in each team's project, create a service account. Download a JSON key for that service account and grant the Kubernetes Engine developer IAM role to that service account in that project. Then create a single project for cloud build that all the teams will use. In that project, encrypt all the service account keys by using cloud KMS. Grant the cloud KMS crypto key decryptor IAM role to cloud build service account. Ask each team to include in their cloudbuild.yaml files a step that decrypts the key of their service account and use their key to connect their cluster. That's a long answer. But let's just break it down. And in doing that, you can see immediately you can eliminate it without having to go through 60-70% of this answer option and therefore potentially save time. The first part suggests that we create a new service account and then use that service account to give permissions to do the deployment. But why would we want to do that? Why can't we use the service account automatically created by cloud build? There is no need for us to create a custom service account in this case, so that's not required and not useful also. The second part we already saw, creating a single project for cloud build that all the teams will use is not acceptable. We have a requirement that one team should not have access to the cluster of another team. We want to keep them separate and segregated. So this is not acceptable. The third part about creating the keys and giving each of them permissions without getting into the details, it's just too roundabout and complex method to ensure only particular people access the cloud build and only they have access to what they see. If at all it solves the purpose, it's just too complex anyway. So based on all of this, I'm going to safely eliminate option D. Option C suggests, in each team's project, list the service accounts and identify the one used by cloud build for each project. In each project, grant the Kubernetes Engine developer IAM role to the service account used by cloud build. Ask each team to execute cloud builds in their own project. Breaking down each of those options, the first one says, find the service account that is automatically created by cloud build. Just use that. And that's a great option. There's no reason to use any individual person's account. There's no reason to create a new account. Just use the one that is already there. Then, grant this service account the Kubernetes Engine developer IAM role. Now, as we saw in the beginning, the default cloud build role has some permissions, but not everything, obviously. If you wanted to deploy to Kubernetes, then you need permissions like a Kubernetes Engine developer IAM, that role and the associated permissions. So we have to add that to the service account. So that's good too. In doing this, now your team members can access the cloud build specifically for their own project. There's no reason to have a common project or to share projects. Considering all of this, therefore, it meets all the requirements of this question, and therefore we can choose this as the correct answer. All right, now it's time for you to like, share, comment, and subscribe. Go ahead, do that right now, because there's loads of great content coming up for learning Google Cloud and preparing for the certifications.